Who are lay people? Are they simply people with little to no academic education? Or are they basically anyone who doesn't belong in the scientific community? You might be thinking, after all, we had to work so hard to enter this elite club of scientists. So surely there should be something that separates us from the crowd? But that's just not right. So who are lay people? If you think this through in an analytic and an unbiased way, just like a real scientist would, you will ultimately come to the conclusion that everybody is a layperson for almost everything, including us scientists. Myself, for example, as a material scientist, I'm an expert in my field, but I'm definitely no expert on butterflies, football, or genetics. In fact, I have no clue about an incredible amount of things, which just means I'm a layperson in all those areas. This is something you should keep in mind when communicating with your audience. How would you like to be treated in a situation where you are the layperson? If you go to the doctor, for example, or if you talk to a mechanic because your car needs fixing, would you want to be lectured in these kinds of situations? Of course not. Nobody does. And yet, we have all been in these situations time and time again. Science has even investigated this issue and found out what is behind this annoying behavior. Many experts, ourselves included, might unconsciously follow what researchers have called the deficit model, which assumes that our lay audience is skeptical about science because they have a knowledge deficit that needs to be eliminated by the profound and the clear knowledge that we as experts can provide them with. One major problem with this model is that it just divides us into experts and non-experts, and that it implicates in a certain way that we as experts have a better standing than the non-experts do, forgetting that everyone is a non-expert in almost everything. It completely disregards the value that an honest dialogue has, where people talk to each other as equals, even though they have different levels and different types of knowledge. Don't forget that our overall goal is gaining trust. Would you trust someone who's just lecturing you? Or would you rather trust a person who is honest about the uncertainties in the data, the doubts they have about the hypothesis, and the limits of the knowledge presented? Scientific knowledge is rarely as certain as we would like for it to be. Talking about these uncertainties and your insecurities makes you more approachable, because now you're communicating with your audience at the human level, meaning that, like everybody else, you might not always be right. Some studies have shown that when scientists or science journalists communicate the uncertainties of the research, the understanding of the whole process of scientific inquiry rises. And understanding how science really works is a prerequisite for trust in science, don't you think? This is not just important for science communication. Some of you have to interact with the lay audience almost every day because that's needed for your research. Maybe you're part of a citizen science project, or lay people are subjects in your study, for example, in medicine or in anthropology. If the latter is the case, you probably already know that there are specific ethical frameworks that need to be followed when you're interacting with lay people. You can find some examples on our website, and your professional society might even offer some ethical frameworks on how to interact with lay audiences that fit the needs of your field. However, it is important that you don't use those guidelines in a purely mechanical way. Instead, you need to consider each individual case. When interacting with lay people in science, always keep in mind that they may not meet many scientists, and the impression that you give them might have an impact on their view of science in general. So always show science from the best side, and also teach your students to interact with lay people in an ethical way. I would like to close with a remark about a virtue that is now seldom considered to be a virtue. And Harvard professor Sheila Jasanoff believes that it will help you to develop the right attitude when interacting with lay people. I'm talking about humility. Humility will show you that scientific knowledge is not the solution for every problem, and that lay people can often contribute substantial ideas and important perspectives to an ongoing debate. So be humble and listen.